This level sucks. Donald, can you reach? You can reach! Kill this guy! And then Sully will stand on the space. So we'll have that one taken care of. Actually, Sully's good for moving around. Maybe I don't want her on the space. If someone else can reach, I'll put them instead. But I doubt anyone else can. Yeah, no one else can. So Sully, you go there for now. I can move you later if I don't like you there. I'm not going to waste a physic on someone who's a space away. So, Krom, you kill this guy with Falchion. Olivia, do nothing. Muriel, go here. You go forward and wait, I guess. And Morgan has to take a step back and attack. I guess, Sumi, you keep going. I need two people over here. One to kill this guy, one to get on the space. I'll just go over here and start by killing him. If I hit, that is. Ow. Yay! Everyone else, forward! As forward as you can go. Guys, you're still waiting. Livia, you're still waiting. Basilio, you're still waiting. And I'm attacking, the boss is attacking me. I'm not worried at all. I might kill the boss this turn. That would be great if I can kill all the units before the next turn happens, because then they won't get any reinforcements. And my abilities have all come in handy this battle. That was great. I told you all these abilities would come in handy. They're not just activating for the fun of it. And I don't think... oh no, Muriel will kill it! She has Arquind equipped! This might be the end of the chapter! Yay! Yes! Ha! Yes! Oh, I'm so happy we're done with that pile of crap. That was a perfect way to end it, too. They died by attacking me. So, yay, that's over. And it was a lot less painful than I thought it would be. I thought we had a couple more turns to go, but whatever. So we're at the altar. Cross, be careful. Gee, I wonder if Krom will be okay. Wouldn't it just suck if he just died on the spot because he's not worthy? That would be a very anticlimactic ending. So yeah, please give me your power, blah blah blah. And it's Naga, apparently. I don't know if we're actually seeing this or if Krom is just seeing it in his head. They never really show it. It's just this portrait of her. Be welcome, Awakener. So your heart has been deemed worthy, cleansed my fire, desire to prevent the burn the stronger. Will you grant me the power to defeat Grima? The power of a god? Yes, but know this, I am no god. But you're the divine dragon! So name me, I'm no creator, I possess not the powers of making or unmaking, I'm just a super duper powerful frickin' dragon, and so is Grima. Neither of us bears the power to destroy the other utterly. But then what can you grant me? You may draw forth Falchion's true might. So basically, Falchion is going to be upgraded, and it's now the strongest sword in the game. And it's also super effective against Grima when we do that. Lucina's parallel Falchion is also super effective against Grima, so. The only power that could truly end Grima would be his own, because that's the only thing that's powerful enough. I see. He has to kill himself? Yeah, but he'd never do that, obviously. That would be the stupidest idea ever to think he'd actually do that. But yeah, the only way for Grima to die is something that is him to kill him. They never really explain why, because I don't know why Grima has the power to destroy Grima, but Naga does not. Oh, shut up, Anna. I don't want to take a break. I don't know if you saw the bottom screen, but it was Anna saying for her to take breaks. Alright, in this shop, you can buy all the really strong magics. Speaking of really strong magics, I am going to switch out Arc Thunder for Thoron. And Bolganon's now my weakest. Well, Bolganon and Thoron are kind of the same thing, but thunder magic is stronger than fire, but fire's more accurate. And wind is even more so. There was something I wanted to give someone. Can't think of what it was. Oh yeah, there are some other Superior Jolt, Katarina's Bolt. I don't think those are that strong, to be honest. Yeah, it's not any stronger than Bolganon. So I just knew I had other weapons that I got from like special stuff, and I wanted to see if anyone could make use of them. Oh, Soul and Amatsu. I forgot about those. Gaius, you take Amatsu. You're the only one who can wield it. Only Swordmasters can wield that. And, I guess I don't really need Soul. You have Balmung, for crying out loud. And the only sword users, Crom and Lucina, don't need it, because they have other stuff that's really good. So, yeah. I don't have enough units to use all the stuff that I have. Which is, that's an okay problem to have. I never gave Olivia a Killing Lance. That's the best thing she can wield, and I don't have one that has a lot of use. I guess I have to buy one for her, but maybe I don't want to, because I don't really care about her. Sorry, Olivia. So we're gonna do this. Second to last chapter of the game. We're on the approach to Grima. At Origin Peak. Alright, we're about to do this chapter. I switched around some people's items. They're not important. Let's do it! Chapter 25, To Slay a God. And yes, this is the second to last level of the game. So, here we go. Origin Peak. The Fell Dragon is indeed there. You know, isn't he like monstrously sized? Wouldn't we see him if he was there? Whatever. Forever Awakener, the power I gave you cannot destroy Grima.
I see.
Can only put him back to sleep. Correct, Fell Blood. So you know of my lineage. You possess power not so different from my own. We must find some way to break this unholy cycle. We can't just keep putting Grima back to sleep every few centuries. Otherwise, we merely will be his vet. I think that's a bad sentence. Otherwise, we merely will his vengeance on our descendants. Yeah, that's not a sentence. Nice try, Crom. Nice try. That made no sense at all. I may know a way. Yes, you have some strategy?
Yeah.
Yes, tip the scales, of course. But no, he and I are the same. If I struck the final blow, technically he'd be killed by his own hand.
Really?
Aquablade, ingenious! Naga, will it work? Perhaps, but there'd be consequences. Grima's heart and Aquablade's heart and Aquablade's would be linked, because technically we're the same person. Dragon and man can no longer be separated. Therefore, slaying Grima would also cause the end of Aquablade's life. I realize that. My body is ready. There's a chance you could just survive, very little, but you have to be bound to this world really tightly, and yeah. So yeah, at the very end, we're going to have a choice between slaying him with Crom or Aquablade. Slaying him with Crom will result in putting him back to sleep, and Aquablade will be slaying him for good, but I will die. It doesn't really matter what I say here, this is just me, I'm going to say yes. I'm going to lie. Or, I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do yet, to be honest, at the end. but, yeah, I don't like that I have to say one right now. It's like pointless to say that conversation, because you can still choose the last second what you want to do. Okay, no Basilio. Now, this map is just, it's hard, but it's not very fun. But it's not as hard as the last one. And it's a little slightly more fun than the last one, too. And there's just a lot of units. That's the reason why it's pretty difficult. There's a lot of units to fight, and they're all really strong. So that's the gist of this one. And there's also two ways to go. So once again, we will have to split up the team. Which way should Kellum go? He's the healer. If we had Kellum and Lissa, this would be easy. But no, Lissa had to die. Alright, does that look like a good setup? Whichever way Olivia goes is gonna be basically not even a person, so ignore Olivia entirely. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Kellum can't count as a last member because he doesn't fight. Okay, I can tell. I know which way. I know how I'm gonna do this. Okay, I know how I'm gonna do this. Let us begin, Aversa. Do you see what your greatest struggle has won you? Nothing! Master Grimm has returned! The world's fate is sealed! Or perhaps you simply seek a tender embrace here at the end, hmm? I'm not completely cruel, you know. Come, I have a kiss for each of you. Ugh, that gives me chills. Alright! Now we kill things. Hammer time! No need for a soul on the very first attack of the game, but... And yeah, they're gonna hit every attack, even with 38% chances and things like that. So yeah, this should be fun. Okay, Jal, can you reach? You can throw short spear. Go ahead and do that, because it's a swordmaster. I don't think anyone else will attack twice. Aether. Congrats, Kijel. You did it. Dang. My units are so great. Alright, can Lucina kill this guy? Yes, because she has an armor slayer! That's why she can kill this guy. Aether! That wasn't necessary, but thank you. Yeah, my units are done with the game, too. They're like, we're gonna just murder all of these people. Just utter destruction on all sides. And I will heal Gregor. And if you notice, I have a physic staff. I should be able to use it after I grow one more staff level, which should be right now. And that was a great level up. Good job, me. Yeah, level C. So yeah, I can use physic now. Having two physic users is gonna be great. So I might demote myself to a healer for the last chapter, but I don't know. I kind of want to fight Grima. Alright, so how many people are on that side? That's all 7 of them. The rest are going the other way. Wait. One of them went the wrong way. Darn it. Oh well. I'll figure it out who that was in a second. Guys, use a Matsu. You can't attack twice in the Swordmaster! What are you good for?! Whatever, go for this guy, I guess. Death.
Sweet.
Alright, the other guys can get hit. Sumia, can you attack twice in the Swordmaster? You cannot, but guys, the 78%, the dual strike a thing, and I'll use Killer Lads just in case of criticals. Luna! I don't think that won't be helpful, but thank you, though. We need guys to get a dual strike! And he did! Yay! Good job, guys! And that's why people should get married, because they have really high dual strike rates. And Laurent, you do an arc wind here. What kind of data did we just get, Laurent? I'm confused. Yay. Alright, yeah, Muriel, keep going. Kellum, keep going. And Rally, for no reason. And Olivia, you just stay out of danger. I don't know what you're gonna be good for, but... Actually, I like the formation I made up. I don't know who went the wrong way, but I think we're actually going to be fine the way we're doing it. Wow, fun. Does Krem not... Is Krem not wielding a weapon? It looks like he's not holding anything. Whatever. And why is the Trickster going for Kellum? He's a defensive unit. On both the defense and resistance fields. And this guy's going for Lucina. You know, I think this is one of the only levels in the game where the Trickster class is present throughout a lot of it. I don't recall them being prominent in like any other chapter. I mean, that was the class Gangrel was, but other than him, I don't recall any others, to be honest. I'm sure there's a few others thrown in here and there, but this is the only chapter I know of where they're prominent. Alright, are these flyers? I hate them. I don't really know what to do about them, though. Yeah, Morgan, you can do something to them. You could probably kill all of them, to be honest. I know you can't kill them all in one turn, but whatever, I'll just let them approach. They're not that dangerous. Or I'll kill them with Selly. Selly can get back easily because she flies. You may use Silver Axe. Yay, Dual Strike, which didn't help, but thank you. And whatever, just kill him. Who cares at this point? We shouldn't have him approach. What am I talking about? You might not kill him. Unless you use arm ads. I don't know if I want to waste arm ads. Even then, you might not hit both times. So let's just go with Killer Axe. Yay! Woohoo! We're getting really strong here. Alright, let's continue our approach up this way. Donald, kill this guy. Oh, what? It's just wow. Donald is so friggin' overpowered. It's amazing. Alright, I can't attack twice. Screw that. We're just gonna have Kjell be up here. She still has her frickin' Iron Lance. Well, we're gonna stop using that immediately. We're gonna equip the Silver Lance. And then I am gonna stand here next to Donald, Rally, and Lucina. I should have actually healed Lucina now that I think about it. I think she'll be fine, though. Right? Yeah, she should be fine. Let's wield Mercurius. Now for this side, Laurent, you might as well take care of one of these guys. And critical, which didn't help. But hey, the abilities are activating. And they have been helpful lately, so I really can't complain. Just for funsies, let's see what Olivia can do. Oh, so close! Maybe she can kill this guy with the Beast Killer! Because they have less defense! She actually can! Oh my god! Olivia is actually helpful! Unless she misses one of these two attacks. She did not! Nice job, Olivia! I know she got extremely hurt from that attack, but whatever. We can fix that. And I have to use Helica's Gale to kill this guy. That's okay. This is the second to last chapter of the game. I think it's okay if we use it up. And I'm pretty sure I'm not going to have it equipped for the last level. I'm going to only have her use Vel Flame the whole time. Gaius, you can kill this guy. You can do so with Killing Edge. I didn't realize how low accuracy Amatsu had. That was interesting. I didn't notice until I just compared it to his other swords. And we're getting a lot of levels this level. Astra! That's a great ability! Honestly, we probably don't even need Lethality anymore, but... you know what? Let's get rid of Lock Touch. There are no more treasure chests in the game. So, yeah, that would make the most sense to get rid of. Krom and Sumia, you go up here. Krom, you need to wield the Exalted Falchion. And Sumia, you stand here. You're going to wield the Silver Lance. And Kellum, you just be awesome. Stand over here and rally everyone. Oh no, they're going for... That's actually a decent hit chance, but it didn't hit. Are you going for Krami? Kill a lance, but still 0% chance. And Aether! Yay! Aether that might matter! And a critical! A critical and an Aether that totally mattered. Thank you, Krom. Nice job.